so much good stuff going on in Fairfield, it's hard to know where to start. But let's go ahead and kick right off with the Business Improvement Awards. In order to keep the evening moving, because I know, as Dietra said, you don't want to stay here until tomorrow sometime, we'll have the award recipients come to the stage on the west side and come across to the east. We'd like you to gather by the chamber sign for a professional photo, thanks to our own Werner Elmker. And those photos will be made available to you and to your businesses, so we'll have them ready for you. Sound like we can do that? Okay. The first Business Improvement Award goes to Agri-Industrial Plastics. We're excited. That's where it's at. This company is here about every year for some sort of award. They are the leading industrial blow molder of large-scale industrial parts, including non-automotive fuel tanks for turf equipment, power sports, agricultural, and marine industries. They've done a total remodel out at their place, and you know they've had so many additions. We joked one year that you could land a 747 on their business, but they're continually working to improve it. They have a new office area to accommodate their incredible growth. They have an open plan that enhances collaboration and teamwork. They've added a large conference space that's used for education, as well as all of the things they're doing out there, and had a wonderful kickoff celebrating the founder, Dick Smith's birthday recently. Congratulations. Our second recipient is Hawthorne. This is the place to work, I'm telling you. They've relocated to West Tyler. They have provided for their staff an open, collaborative, and also private office spaces out there. They really are working hard to foster a positive work life with a focus on the quality of life of their staff as well as wellness. And this includes both internal and external improvements. They've added very modern touches with minimalization while highlighting the natural elements of the building that they have now acquired. Everyone has windows and natural light, and we know what a healthy thing that is for people. They're right next to Jefferson County Park, and they have the trails for their staff. They do walking meetings on those trails. Real blue zones, that's what we want to hear. They have Wi-Fi enabled their outdoor spaces so that staff can work outside. They have a dedicated exercise facility for their staff. Does that sound like the place to work? Well, I'm thinking so. So congratulations to all of you. Our next recipient is Health and Wholeness. What an asset to our community. Nicole Barron-Cruz used her extensive knowledge of the retail environment and the culture for the store move and the renovation to really make it something special. Utilized Matt Johnson, who created a 3D visual floor plan so they could go over every aspect of this to make it the award-winning environment that it is. What a wonderful addition for our community. Congratulations. Our next recipient is Iowa Wind and Solar. Their company motto is Be Bright. I loved that when I read it, Be Bright. They provide tailored turnkey solutions, and they're passionate about making a positive impact on our environment as well as keeping a strong eye on financial stewardship. They moved from the square to the industrial park and renovated their workspace to make it an ideal workplace for your employees. The compliment, Be Bright, came because they have lots of natural light and bright colors carried through their open, modern concept. They added standing, convertible desks, lots of live plants, again, blue zones, break areas, and they're looking forward to more in 2017. Congratulations. Jody's Touch. Ah, the joy of being able to go and have all these wonderful things done and turn you out so that you look really fantastic. for at least 5 minutes until you're out in the Iowa weather. Jody just keeps kicking it up a notch all the time. She removed two walls at her place to give her establishment an extra 600 square feet. That allowed for two new stations and two new shampoo bowls, I understand. Redid the floors with partial stained concrete and laminates, new lighting, and upgraded their business plan so that they can facilitate people who want to just rent a space and those who also want to work as commission-based stylists. She's added those things so that she can meet the individual needs of folks in our community who'd like to provide those services and now can have a place. She's also offering rental suites, and we congratulate her on doing all of this. Shokai Sushi, yum, how about that? These folks moved to the northeast corner of the square and went from 900 square feet to 2,000 square feet. They also have additional outdoor dining and a 900 square foot private room and lounge. They now also have a 400 square foot kitchen to make those delicacies that so many of you have come to love. The Morgan crew hand-built the walls, the trims, the doors, and the bars. They had drop ceilings that they removed to reveal 13-foot ceilings in that wonderful old building. Hardwood bamboo floors, they added granite tabletops and bar tops from Creative Edge. Wow. What a nice place to be able to go and enjoy a lovely evening. Congratulations. Signs and Designs came to town. They're new to Fairfield, and we're pretty darn glad to have them. They are a one-stop shop for products that identify you and can help market your business. From apparel to vehicle graphics, they sponsor, assist, and volunteer their labor time and materials to produce visual graphics and signs to help school children and teams with uniforms and t-shirts, and they already feel like they're family in our community, which is a core philosophy in this community. So we couldn't be happier to have these folks with us, and check them out sometime. Thank you, congratulations. Simply Thrive, Weight Loss Center of Southeast Iowa, LLC. What a great addition for us. Marsha Locks researched many food and market factors and recognized organic, clean, raw foods are the keys to health. Started the business in 2014 and lost 100 pounds herself on this program. She and her husband Dennis found the Qingdao building in 2015, and with the help of their daughter Brooke and their son-in-law, Clayton Lilly, they gutted the original building, and that was a gas station, actually. We would have to go back maybe even older than I am, if you can imagine that, and renovated it both inside and out to make a farmhouse-like theme. So that is a great thing. She has a demo kitchen and hosts healthy cooking and freezer meal workshops for busy families. And she's added Brenda Halls, an advanced registered nurse practitioner who's lost 85 pounds herself and joins a team, I think, of seven coaches. So we have it right here in our community, and congratulations to all of you. Now here's a name you haven't heard tonight, Sweet and Saucy. How about that? Who enjoyed their meal tonight? Yes, you bet. These folks expanded into the building next door. They made a new dining room, they doubled their seating, and they've added fun decor for any of you who haven't actually been there. They converted their own dining room into three times their original kitchen space, I think. Upgraded most all of their equipment, and it has allowed them to really expand their business, their catering, their vending, and their restaurant side. they are able to do events of 500 and possibly even more. So if you haven't been over there, you've had a taste of it tonight. Give it a chance. Give it a chance. It's good stuff. And they have more to come, they tell us as well. Congratulations. Greater Fairfield Area Habitat for Humanity Restore. A great win for our community, and it would be a win-win on both sides. Now there's a place to take all my stuff. And you know what? They've got all kinds of stuff there. If you haven't been there, they have a brand new location. They outgrew their old one, and they acquired the old one-stop rental business on Business 34. But it wasn't big enough either, so they set about pulling everybody together and built a huge addition onto it. Better location, layout, lighting, and they waited until we had the dog days of summer. Anybody live through any of those in Iowa here? The staff and volunteers worked diligently and undertook the monumental job of moving everything to their new place, cleaning it out. And again, if you haven't been there, you need to go. You know, I thought it would be doors and fences and things. But you can't believe what they have there. It's incredible. Huh? Furniture, dishes, they've got it. Yep, you gotta go. Another place to shop in Fairfield. Congratulations. Our next recipient is, am I going too fast for it? Is the Hideaway Pub, a place where everybody knows your name. Unfortunately, nobody can be here from there tonight, but they've added an outdoor patio. Outdoor patio improvements, and for the first time in their history, they added signage as well. They removed their own old tin shed and built a nice wooden shed and painted it to match the building. They added stone pillars and lighting for a softer look and for safety as well. And there's much more to come this year, I understand. A stage for music and a margarita shack. More paint and more fixtures, so congratulations to the Hideaway. Then this old barn. How many of you have been to this old barn for something out there? Yeah. Okay. It is a fantastic place, and it's a must-see, and unfortunately, no one can be here tonight from there either, but they did a complete renovation to include a kitchen, a bar, restrooms, a patio. They decided to put an authentic red exterior stain to match old barns on the exterior and did a huge landscaping project that includes a waterfall, flower beds, planted 23 trees out there, a new lawn, antique brick sidewalk, outdoor wedding areas, gathering spaces, and they have more to come too. So congratulations to this old barn. And now something near and dear to all of us is Leadership Fairfield. And Lindsay Waugh, who is our lead person on Leadership Fairfield, is going to take over.
Thank you, Johnny. We're already about halfway through. How's everybody doing? Thank you to those of you that have come out here tonight to support Fairfield's vibrant business community. I hope each of you are enjoying visiting with your friends, coworkers, and possibly even customers. So much of what Dietra mentioned earlier that the Chamber hopes to accomplish is offering networking opportunities such as tonight. There is a particular program that stands out as the ultimate networking opportunity. Leadership Fairfield, which has just completed its third year and is accepting applications for the next session. This program was originally incubated with the help of Ashley Moyer from Indian Hills Community College. It was modeled after Leadership Iowa with 8 monthly sessions that each has a unique theme. The structure is primarily based around guest speakers, panels of community leaders, and tours of Fairfield businesses. For an example, during the education session, we might visit MUM's campus. Finance Day, we might have a panel of local local insurance representatives, bankers, or perhaps investment brokers. And during the government session, Supervisor Dick Reeve gives a fantastic tour of the courthouse. By the end of the course, our goal is that each participant has a well-rounded knowledge of the main business sectors in Fairfield and has personally met those that manage these successful organizations. In addition to attending the 8 sessions, the requirements include presenting your personal elevator pitch, attending a public board meeting, working in a group, and volunteer hours. Alumni from the previous year are asked to facilitate a session the following year, which creates an additional opportunity for leadership. The next Leadership Fairfield session begins September 12th. If you're interested or if you would like to sponsor an employee to enroll in the program, pick up an application at the registration desk on your way out. And if you're always welcome to stop in the chamber for additional details. And keep in mind, if your business is interested in serving on a panel, offering a tour, contact the chamber and we will get you plugged in. Without further ado, on behalf of the Fairfield Area Chamber of Commerce, we would like to honor and congratulate the most recent class of leadership Fairfield. This session began back in August and it has been such a pleasure getting to know each of you. As I call your name, please come across to receive your certificate, and after we're through, we'll pose for a group photo over here. Bailey Bainbridge from Washington State Bank, who was unable to make it tonight. Jackie Bookin Nospish from Jefferson County Health Center. Jeff Guthrie from Agri Industrial Plastics Company. Tori Hollingsworth from Fairfield Arts and Convention Center. Brian Hunger, Jefferson County Health Center. Joshua Larrabee, Fairfield Economic Development Association. Russ McGee, Iowa State Bank. Murray Metcalf, Cambridge Investment Research. Carol Passos from Maharishi University of Management. Desiree Ringey from Fairfield Line. Alicia Scholl, Fairfield Community School District. Chelsea Soans, MidWestOne Bank. Joe Stever, Edward Jones Investments. Please once again join me in giving these dedicated leaders a round of applause.
Our next award is the Community Improvement Award. It's sponsored by Foss, Kiken, and Cochran. And this award is given in recognition of notable contributions that enhance and benefit the residents and the community of Fairfield. This year's recipients is the Young Professionals of Fairfield. It's a networking organization for people 21 to 40. I wanted them to invite me, but something was wrong, I guess, with that. If I squint into the mirror, I could fit that group, I'm telling you. They focus on cultivating community awareness and providing professional and social and volunteer opportunities to the members. They meet monthly for self-development and, again, volunteering business tours. And if you'd ever like to host them, let the chamber know. Congratulations. The next award is the Green Business Award. It's sponsored by Global ID, and it's given in recognition of an outstanding project which creates a lasting positive impact on the natural environment, and it goes to Schaus Voorhees Manufacturing. These folks have a long history of community-oriented and sustainability-focused projects with emphasis on LEED milestones. They restored an industrial brownfield to a sustainable clean energy source. On a former contamination site, they put in a $1.2 million solar field. Half a megawatt array is the largest privately owned industrial solar installation in the state. It covers 100% of the company's electrical needs and will pay for itself in 5 to 6 years. These folks also, I think, power our greenhouse as well. So congratulations to Shouse Voorhees. Our next award is the Impact Award, and it's sponsored by Cambridge Investment Research. This award is given in recognition of a business or organization for their in-depth, long-term contribution to the Fairfield community over many years. This year, the award goes to the Jefferson County Trails Council. These folks have made an impressive addition to our community. The idea of the Loop Trail was first conceived in 97. We now can boast 30 plus miles of interconnected trails, all within a 3 mile radius of downtown Fairfield. They continue impacting by doing all kinds of things over time. A trail bridge to at Walton Lake, limey chips and calcium chloride on Mint Boulevard, trailhead kiosks, Loop Trail maps, 18 bicycle racks along the trail, collaboration with First National Bank for photo competitions, for calendars, out of community promotion of the trails. They got, I believe it's a $320,000 DOT grant, is that right, Stephen? For the trail connection to the Jefferson County Health Center. The Cedar View Bypass Bridge. They collaborated with Shouse Voorhees Manufacturing, Community First, and Judy Bales for the Nuts and Bolts Bridge Refurbishing Project. They host an annual scavenger hunt. It never stops. We are so blessed to have this system, and congratulations. The Interactive Media Award is sponsored by Hawthorne, and it's given in recognition of the best website or blog of the year, and it goes to Food Chain ID. There was a committee of people that reviewed a number of websites, and these folks came out on top. They are a technical administrator of the non-GMO project, very impactful, user-friendly, engaging, in their new redesigned website. They certify over 80% of the products receiving the non-GMO Project Verified Butterfly label. And their website adds a very positive spin to the marketplace and the perceptions of these products. Thank you and congratulations. The new Young Business of the Year Award is sponsored by Natel Broadband, and it recognizes a business who entered their first year of existence in 2016 and made marked improvements to their space of operation. And this year's recipient is Main Street Donuts. Anybody been there? That's a must stop by for sure. They came to Fairfield to share their elegantly luscious creations. They're located in the Orpheum. They now have parking and no steps, so it's easy to get there. And it's not just for coffee anymore. You can have it anytime you want. Congratulations. The Progress Award is sponsored by First National Bank, and it recognizes a business or organization for their demonstrated progressive innovations. And this year it goes to Fairfield CoLab. What is it, you say? Well, it's a place where people can go to share ideas and initiatives. They can sit side by side instead of having these wonderful brain trusts working out of their basement. They now can work side by side with other creative, knowledgeable people to do all sorts of wonderful things. 35 people each put in $35 apiece to be founding members, created a 501c3, landed a place in the Bunnell building, and extensively renovated it. A total of $32,000 was donated because of the interest and generosity of folks like all of you. That's what Fairfield's about. People who care and step to the plate when there are needs. They open their doors, and the usual saying, the rest is history, is not the case with these folks. In their case, the rest of the story is just being written. Congratulations. The Rising Star Award is sponsored by Danaher Oil Company, and it recognizes a business or organization in their second or third year of existence and making outstanding contributions to the Fairfield area. And this year it goes to County Cider Works. Anybody try any of the cider tonight? Was it appealing? So Jesse Narducci and Katie Greenfield moved home and started a hard cider company. They created a tap room to share their cider and a place where people want to go and spend some time and relax and enjoy themselves. They're also into distribution now and deliver kegs, and soon they will deliver bottles as well throughout southeast Iowa. If you haven't tried those ciders, I'm sorry, I think we're out tonight, but you can... They can show you where to go to get it. Congratulations. And finally, the Wellness Award that recognizes a business or organization for serving as a role model for health and wellness for the community. This year's recipient is near and dear to my heart, Jefferson County Health Center. Jefferson County Health Center constructed a safe, reasonably flat 0.9-mile addition to the Loop Trail as an extension of the philosophy that helping people learn to stay well is equally as important to taking care of people when they're ill. Also, it exemplifies the spirit of JCHC in giving back to our community. Originally, there were 3 fitness stations installed on this Loop Trail, but the health center has added 9 more fitness stations. They have made them available for all ages and all abilities, and they're available 24/7. They've added self-guided signage so that you know what to do when you get to whatever it is out there on the trail. Each area has been landscaped with trees, shrubs, and flowers. Everyone deserves to be healthy and live a long and happy life, and that's what Jefferson County Health Center is all about. Congratulations. And now it's that time of the evening that many of you come just to see or hear about, and that is the Citizen of the Year. I am honored to be able to work with the first Citizen of the Year in Dr. Larry Nash's place. He's unable to be with us tonight as a recipient. Last year, he would normally be here awarding this very prestigious honor. From a very early age, this person's children learned to pick up trash and grab the stray shopping carts that were hanging out around the stores when they were out and about. Modeling those giving back values for them to see and to emulate has been an important part of this person's life. This person is described as a small person with a tremendously big heart who works tirelessly to better the community through bettering the lives of people who live here. This person is especially dedicated to cancer. Cancer research and support and co-chairs the Jefferson County Relay for Life. They're a team captain and serve on various committees to help make it such a successful event every year. The fundraising goal of this person is zero expense. And this person goes after it. That's a big challenge for anybody who's worked with fundraising. For the last 5 years, this person organized a silent auction in memory of Sandy Worley, who fought a valiant fight with cancer. The dollars go to raise awareness and help fund those living with cancer and to help find a cure. This also keeps Sandy's memory alive in the minds of all who knew and loved her. This person laid the groundwork for the Relay for Life calendar, featuring many local people who are dealing with cancer, and their families too, lives that have been touched by these devastating diseases. This person organized Pitch for the Cure, Shop for the Cure, Photos with Santa, which offers family photos with Santa at a very reasonable fee, last year raising $2,000. Last year, her team raised $12,000. Now, since the Chamber's no longer doing the citywide garage sale, she organized it for Relay for Life, and the proceeds from all of these events go to Relay for Life. She's kind and caring and throws her all into everything she does. The legwork she's put in could have allowed her to walk the Komen walk several times over. Quote, she goes above and beyond to support the mission and programs of the American Cancer Society. Her passion and dedication to the cause is inspiring to those who serve with her. This person served an entire term on the Fairfield Area Chamber of Commerce board. While on the board, she worked her tail off on chamber events such as this banquet and the men's and women's blast-offs. She's a tremendous promoter. To help bring these premier facilities to our community, this person has been a member of the Fairfield Pool and Recreation Fundraising Team. This person created and maintains Fairfield Freecycle Bicycle Site, buy as in give money and get something, on Facebook. This is a site for people to give away, to buy, to sell. Currently, there are over 6,000 people who use this site. This person also maintains the Fairfield Memorial site on Facebook. The site is designed to remember classmates, teachers, and loved ones who have passed. And she is a huge Fairfield promoter. She runs a campaign called Buy Fairfield First to promote local businesses and restaurants. She has promoted and volunteered for First Friday Artworks. This person was concerned for a young woman needing a kidney transplant and organized a pizza tip night that raised over $2,300, to help her. Then she did the same for a person needing extensive back surgery and who was very worried about financially how their family would manage when she had to have this done. Another person told of a family who were without food. This person stepped to the plate, got a hold of the resources, and managed to get them food to tide them over until the next paycheck could come. Her most recent fundraiser was for another person in need and raised $1,700. She's always there, volunteering her time and talents to better the lives of others. Quote, this person's considered the go-to person who's contacted multiple times a day for what's happening or for those needing information. She finds the answers and gets the results. To honor a very special man, Paul Knox, and to raise awareness for amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, which is Lou Gehrig's disease, she organized the Ice Bucket Challenge. His family describes her as a lovely lady and friend who created an amazing experience by drawing complete strangers from our community together. This was because she set her mind to it, got busy, and made it happen. Our community is honored to have Matt Stutzman, Paralympics archer, who brought home a silver medal for all of us. This person organized a surprise homecoming parade complete with police, fire, and a long line of cars waiting for Matt's arrival. Burlington Street was lined on both sides with people with flags, and hundreds were waiting on the square, all because of her efforts. This person was president of the junior ROTC for 3 years. She was enthusiastically, this is a quote, instrumental in planning numerous events, pancake breakfasts, annual steak night fundraisers, semi-annual highway cleanup, and the formal JROTC Cadet Ball, all in support of the program. This person assists with the annual Lions Club Spaghetti Supper, the Rotary Auction, and the Fairfield Booster Club selling sports decals, with all the money going to the Booster Club. As if she doesn't have enough to do, she saves pop tabs and box tops for other people's children in schools to help support the schools. This person reared two children, excuse me, and when they were full grown, decided to give back. She and her husband fostered two children and eventually adopted both of them so these brothers would not be separated. She manages to balance a husband, a family of four, a full-time job, which includes a fair amount of travel. She's an outstanding example of how one person can make a huge impact on many. Excuse me. It isn't cider. Quote, she has taught me to be humble and to be there for people, not for the notability, but to be the person who does this from the heart, just as we all should serve humbly. Quote, she demonstrates the teamwork, discipline, and true characteristics of a caring person who wants to do good for others. She also has the ability and character to choose to do the right thing rather than the easy wrong thing. Her ability and desire to help others is just part of her nature and a truly beautiful thing. Many of us see needs in our community, but when she sees a need, she acts on it. Her selflessness is a mark of a true community hero. Please join me in congratulating our 2017 Citizen of the Year, Dawn Ridgway Bechtel.
I'm blinded. Wow, this is a real honor and a surprise. I really don't know really what to say, but I really started the Fairfield Free Cycle site when Fairfield quit doing their citywide pickup, and I felt that I always saw my mother, you're supposed to be at the Ozarks. I just talked to her a little bit ago and she was telling me how she was going out to dinner. they would put their recycling out on the curb, and by the time the citywide people or they came and picked it up, there wouldn't be much left. And I always saw that a lot of people would go around and pick up and recycle, and recycling is just really near and dear to my heart. So I started the site, and we only had a few hundred members for a long time, and it took a long time to get it up to where it is. And I really must thank Shea Barber for also helping me. He is my right and left arm on that site. And as far as the, I've lost my mother-in-law to cancer and lost Sandy Worley to cancer. It really means a lot to me to raise money and hope that someday we don't have to hear that diagnosis that someone has cancer. So I have a great team. The Cancer Exterminators is the name of our team. And Kim Bradfield takes those photos. She spends hours. We do the Santa shoot. We did an Easter shoot actually last weekend and raised $1,000, and we're going to do it again on Thursday. And the Santa shoot has just gotten bigger and bigger every year, so I really appreciate them. And lastly, I couldn't do this if it wasn't for my family. My folks help out a lot with the Sandy Worley auction. And my husband is not above doing the laundry and the dishes, and thank goodness he cooks for us. And the boys help. They would always go to the bank and set up for me so that was done. And I just thank them for allowing me the freedom. And also my boss, I can't forget him as well. I still have to do my job, but I do have the freedom to do some things. So I really appreciate that. So thank you very much. Oh, Relay for Life is May 6th up on the square from 1 to 9. Please come walk with us. If nothing else, come for the Luminaria lap. It's just really a touching. I walk that lap every year slower than anybody else because I read every single name on every single bag, and I would love it if you guys would join us. And lastly, reduce, reuse, and recycle. Thank you.
Now I'd like to ask Nancy Horace, last year's other recipient of Citizen of the Year, to please come forward to present our other award.
I'm very honored to have been selected along with Dr. Larry Dash as Citizen of the Year last year. Is that okay? It was a great honor for me to have been chosen. And although I've worked very hard to keep up with the fine examples set by my predecessors from the previous year, Mr. Jim Edgton and Mr. Jim Saltz, I have a confession to make. I have fallen short. While Mr. Edgton claimed that the two of them had been arrested 6 times during their term, it has only been 3 for me. When Jim introduced me at this banquet last year and cited my qualifications for the honor, I first thought that he was speaking of somebody else. Then I felt a little surprised that what I would have done would have been worthy of such an honor. And then I wondered whether I'd really done enough to deserve it. I expect those feelings are probably common to past honorees as well. And I know that in spite of all that this nominee has done, the humble person that I am here to present will likely feel the same. Although this Citizen of the Year was not born or raised here, that has not stopped them from becoming involved from almost the moment they arrived. They first got noticed by school and church leaders as a great parent. Sorry if this mic is it too loud? It's okay? All right. But a great parent that not only cared for their own children, but others as well. They were always looking for ways to support and encourage them. This person started sharing their time and talents, serving as a Little League team parent. Quite a few of us out there that have done that. Also, the Fairfield Babe Ruth Baseball League. Active in support of the Fairfield Trojan Booster Club and fundraising activities. In mentioning community service with an accent on supporting youth, it's important to note that this person has been active with young people in their church for all of their adult life, serving as a Sunday school teacher, Bible study leader, fundraiser for youth endowment committee, a chaperone on numerous youth trips and events, and basically being there for any child when needed. One sponsor said it would be impossible to know how many young lives this person has influenced. Their church has benefited from their leadership and energy of this person as well. A supporter wrote that they have been a member of the church endowment committee as well as chaired the pastoral search committee through a process that lasted over 2 years. Our nominee committed to ably chair the church's trustee committee. In their letters of support, sponsors repeatedly point out that this person is selfless, that they put themselves second, not motivated by an agenda, and that they truly serve the needs of that organization and the community. This Citizen of the Year does not limit their involvement to supporting their church, but has found themselves in leadership roles throughout the community. They have served as a team leader among the Partners for Play playground in the construction of the playground at O.B. Nelson Park. They served on the RAGBRAI committee in 2013. Supporters write that service on the Fairfield Pool and Gym Task Force, the foundation board for the Fairfield Park and Recreation Department, the Greater Jefferson County Foundation, the Jefferson County Health Center Foundation, the Board for Career and Technical Education at Fairfield High School are also to this person's credit. One sponsor writes that our nominee is always cheerful, even when there is much work to be done, and generous with their time and talents. They add that this person is on the short list when our community looks for someone who will work hard to make it a better place. Our citizen has served the Fairfield Area Chamber of Commerce in several capacities, including membership on the Christmas Committee for over 15 years, 7 years of service as a director, and was president in 2009. A sponsor commented, "This person approaches her responsibilities with a humble demeanor, showing an endless dedication to improving the community dynamic and a willingness to lend their talents in communication, team building, and problem solving. I know this person best as the consummate professional and a most valued member of our business family. Celebrating her 20th year in association with ERA Fairfield Real Estate, her ethic and empathy have made her the most successful residential salesperson in Fairfield. And her measure of success is universal, not just in thinking in terms of dollars or volume, but considering the number of people she has served, the number of friends she has made, and the number of lives she has impacted. She believes that education is the cornerstone to professionalism, earning her degree in associate's degree in business from Muscatine Community College, obtaining her broker's license, and achieving certified residential specialist, graduate of the Realtors Institute, and the accredited buyer's representative designations. A sponsor commented that for this person, a home is much more than a house. It's about the people. Another added that they've rarely come across a person so attentive to the most minute detail, very determined and effective. Our citizen serves on several professional and industry committees and boards, including the City of Fairfield Housing Task Force. Her mother tells us that her love of family has spilled over to her love of her community. And based of all the things that you've now heard about her, that would certainly appear to be true. She's a devoted wife to her husband, Jeff, a loving mother to sons, Matt and Jake, a doting grandmother to Lyric and Shepherd, and an admiring daughter to Larry and Shirley Porter. Her mother also reported that when she was born on November the 14th, 1963, in St. Charles, Missouri, she had thick black hair. Ladies and gentlemen, I give to you my friend, my favorite blonde, I mean brunette, no, I mean blonde again, 2017 Fairfield Area Chamber of Commerce Citizen of the Year, Tammy Dunbar.
Should have taken advantage of the free drink. I was thinking at the end, why didn't one of my committees have a meeting tonight? I don't even know what to say, but thank you. And I know that anyone who is a volunteer, you know that you can't do it without your family, my husband Jeff, and my sons Matthew and Jake. And I learned at an early age from my grandparents, who took it down through my parents, that you have to give back, that if you keep taking and taking and taking, it will die. So, I don't know what to say. Thank you. I love Fairfield, and I see so many people that I'm on committees with and have had an opportunity to spend time with, so thank you, thank you, thank you.